Hi, this is Bob Kraft from Tennis Ministry International, and I'm sitting here in Hong Kong, seemingly a long way from Melbourne, but it's about an 8-hour flight. I've made that trip 9 years in a row, and this is part two, where we're going to actually be talking a little bit about the men's doubles, and then we'll follow that up with women's singles. But the men's doubles, Bob and Mike, Brian, of course, they're always in the semis or the finals. We're actually down into that point now where we've got four teams. There's a match going on now, and it hasn't been concluded, so I won't talk about that one. But I've got Bob and Mike. I've known them since 2002, and I think what stands out about our relationship is that they've seen me a long time, and I would say they respect me. I've spent a lot of time with them because I've been around a long time, and they've always seen that I've done the same thing, I've said the same thing, I've never deviated from my actions, and I think there's a kind of a respect there that has been built up, and they've always been very helpful. I mean, they've provided credentials for me, they've done things that other players actually didn't do, like give me a coach credential for Brian, and that was an important thing that helped me a lot. And of course, I am a qualified coach, so that it wasn't like he didn't do anything that was really wrong there. But having said that, is they've been a good team to watch, and I've sat in their box. I've been I think now they know that I pray for them, and even though I'm not there, I'm sure that they know that I'm praying from far away. Mike just recently got married to Michelle, and I spent time with them in Beijing few months ago at a tournament, and happily they were married in a church. And as always, I'm just trying my best to encourage people in a positive direction, and helping them to understand that church is not an external part of your life, but it's actually an internal part, and it helps you a lot, so it helps your family. So that's kind of where we're at there. The next players are Buderak and Rozier. I've spent time with Buderak. I've shared. He's from the Midwestern part of the United States, which is where I'm from. But he hasn't really responded. He went to a small college to the faith aspect. But I try my best, and I don't know anything about him. Outside of that, I've tried, and he's always been nice, but never responsive beyond that. So I keep praying, and just hope that things turn out well for him. His teammate, Rozier, I'd never met him. It's like that in doubles. You meet a lot of players that are new, and they're coming up, and they pair up with a new teammate, and they do pretty well in the tournament. And it's always a bit of a juggle to stay on top of the players, the new players. Most of the players play till they're between 32 and 35 in doubles because they have less stress on their body. They don't play five sets. They play two sets and a tiebreaker, or they don't play... the pressure's left less mentally. So that's why there's so many of these players stick around for a long time. You build a relationship with them. Bupati and Paas, now, I've known them since 1996 when they first came to Hong Kong, and I shared the gospel then, no different than I'm doing now. So they've known me a long time. Mahesh is a Christian. He accepted Christ not too many years ago. And you can often see him wearing a cross, and he's been very helpful for me. He's given me credentials. I've sat in his box for many matches, including Grand Slam finals. He's introduced me to people on the tour, and he's been a blessing to be around, and I sincerely wish him the best and hope he makes good decisions and he's getting good Bible material. And then we have Leander. They actually hadn't played together for a few years, but now they're Leander and Mahesh, but they're getting ready. Leander Paas is getting ready for Olympic doubles. His step-parent was a bishop of Calcutta. I think it's kind of more of an external thing for him than an internal thing, but for sure, we always talk about me praying for him, and I know that he knows it's real to my inner spirit. So every time I see him, he told me once, he said, "You're always welcome at my table." And that meant a lot to me. And I try my best to just turn a blind eye from anything that I don't agree with, but at the same time, be caring and supportive. And we wish them the best in this tournament. And it'd be interesting to see them come back after not having played so many years and make it to the finals. So the next part of it will be where we talk about the women's singles, and I hope you tune in for that at our YouTube channel at Tennis Ministry, youtube.com. Thanks a lot.